Hello everyone. In last session, which topic we learned? We learned the topic the sky. In that, what we learned? In the topic the sky, we learned about solar system. Then tell me students, what is solar system? Yes, the sun and its family is known as the solar system. Okay, in solar system, it comprises of 8 planets, 173 satellites, thousands of asteroids, meteoroids and comets. We called as solar system. In solar system, sun is at the center and 8 planets revolving around the sun are orbiting around the sun. Sun is at the center and planets are orbiting around the sun. There are 8 planets. In that, first one is, yes, first one planet name is Mercury, second Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. There are 8 planets in our solar system. Once again, I repeat the names of planets. First one is Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune. There are 8 planets in our solar system. You must remember the names of planets. Observe the picture, students. Is any changes you observe? In solar system, we saw sun is at the center, planets orbiting the sun. But in this picture, earth is at the center, sun, moon and planets orbiting the earth. Am I correct? Okay, this type of model called as geocentric model. Okay. What you mean by geocentric model? In ancient times, people thought that the sun, the moon and the planets were orbiting the earth. This was known as geocentric model. What you mean by geocentric model? Earth is at the center, sun, moon and planets are orbiting the earth. This model we called as geocentric model. Observe the video, students. Earth is at the center. Planets are revolving around the earth. This model we called as geocentric model. Geocentric model was expounded by Claudius Ptolemy. Who is he? He is a Claudius Ptolemy who expounded the geocentric model. What Claudius Ptolemy model in his hand? See students, in his hand we saw geocentric model. Geocentric model means we already know that earth is at the center, sun, moon, planets are revolving or orbiting around the earth. Okay. He is Claudius Ptolemy. He hold the model of geocentric model. According to Claudius Ptolemy, the earth was the center of the universe. What is the center of universe? Earth is the center of universe. Geocentric model was expounded by whom? Yes, tell me, who expounded geocentric model? Claudius Ptolemy expounded the geocentric model. If question ask like, name the model expounded by Claudius Ptolemy, what is the answer? The model name is geocentric model, which is expounded by Claudius Ptolemy. See the next picture. Can you identify who is he? He is Aryabhatta, the first Indian astronomer and mathematician, proposed that the Earth and other planets revolved around the Sun. Okay, see students, the Earth and other planets revolved around the Sun means solar system. We already learned Sun is at the center and planets are orbiting around the Sun is nothing but solar system. This is also known as heliocentric model. Okay, heliocentric model. Sun is at the center, planets are orbiting around the Sun. It is also nothing but heliocentric model. Nicholas Copernicus, who is he? He is a Nicholas Copernicus. Next. Yes, can you identify? Johannes Kepler. He is a Johannes Kepler. He also supported to heliocentric model. Can you identify the picture? It is a picture of Galileo. Galileo, an Indian mathematician and physicist, invented a telescope and using it. See the picture of telescope. Telescope is an instrument used to observe distant objects. Okay. Who invented telescope? Telescope invented by Galileo Galilei. Okay. Galileo Galilei invented telescope. Further, Galileo Galilei supported the heliocentric model of Copernicus. We know that in solar system, how many planets are there? We know, we already learned. That is, in solar system, there are 8 planets. But what actually the planets? Tell me, what do you mean by planets? Planets means a celestial body orbiting around the Sun along an elliptical orbit is called a planet. Here, planets are revolving along a elliptical orbit. So, we called as planet. Every planet has its own path of movement, which is known as the orbit. Okay. See students, the orbit. Every planet rotating in their own path. So, we says that is orbit. Orbit is nothing but a path where planets rotate. Okay, this is known as orbit. The Earth also has its own orbit. The planets are non-luminous bodies. What do you mean by non-luminous bodies? Non-luminous bodies means the planets which not emit their own light. That we called as non-luminous planets. Every planet has non-luminous, but if we say, which is the non-luminous object? What do you mean? Non-luminous object means the object which didn't produce their own light. So, we say that non-luminous objects. When come to orbit, non-luminous orbits means the orbits didn't produce or emit their own light. That types of orbits we called as non-luminous bodies. They receive light and heat from the Sun. Okay, all the orbits receive light and heat from Sun. Celestial bodies means all the objects that we can see in the sky, the types of bodies we say that celestial bodies. Earth is the third planet. Correct. First one is Mercury, second one is Venus, third one is nothing but Earth. Exactly, third one planet is Earth. Earth also receives light and heat from the sun. The strongest source of light in our solar system is one and only the sun. The sun is the strongest source of light and heat in our solar system. See the picture of sun. Sun is also called as star. Now we are going to learn about the sun. The sun is a star. It is closer to the earth than any other star. Therefore, it looks bigger and brighter than all other stars. It is a center of the solar system. It is means sun is the center of solar system. It exerts a gravitational pull on all its members which orbit around it. The sun provides light and heat to us. It appears to rise in the east and set in the west. The heat and light of the sun is essential for human beings, plants and animals. This is about the sun. Let's take a recapitulate what we learned today. See the first question. What is solar system? We already learned solar system means it is a family of sun. Sun and its family we called as solar system. See the answer. The family of the sun is known as the solar system. We know that in solar system there are 8 planets, 173 satellites, thousands of asteroids, meteorites and comets we called as solar system. Let's move the next question. Question number second. Name the planets of our solar system. It is very important question. Must remember the names in order wise. There are 8 planets in the solar system. See the answer. First one planet is Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. There are 8 planets in our solar system. See the next question. Question number 3. What is a planet? Answer is, a planet is a celestial body moving in an elliptical orbit around a particular star. We know that celestial body means all the object that we can see in the sky, we say that celestial body. Planet also celestial bodies because we see in the sky. A planet is a celestial body moving in an, the orbit is in an elliptical form. So we say that elliptical orbit around a particular star. Okay, this is the meaning of planet. Next one is question number 4. Why does the sun look bigger than other bigger stars? Answer is, the sun is closer to the earth than any other bigger stars. So the sun looks bigger to us. Okay, see next question. Question number 5. How are planets different from stars? Answer is, a planet is a celestial body. We know that celestial body means all the objects that we can see in the sky is celestial body. See the answer. A planet is a celestial body moving in an elliptical orbit around a particular star. Okay, so the planets different from stars. Next one is question number 6. What are celestial bodies? We discussed 2 to 3 times. Now let's see the answer. All the objects that we can see in the sky are called celestial bodies. Next, see question number 7. The solar system consists of dash planets. Option A 9, option B 10, option C 8, option D 7. What is the answer? How many planets are there in solar system? There are 8 planets. Option C is the correct answer. Option C 8. Next one is, the sun is a satellite, asteroid, star, comets. We learned about sun. Sun is one of the star. Okay, sun is one of the star. It is not a satellite, not an asteroid, not a comet. Okay, sun is one of the star. Fill in the blanks. First question, the direction where the sun appears to rise is called, yes, tell me, what is the answer? Sunrise from east. Okay, east is the answer. The sun is the source of light and heat. Dash is the source of light and heat. We know the sun, because sun is only a single. So we say that the sun is the source of light and heat. See the third question. A planet is a dash body. Every planet we saw in sky. So we say that a planet is a dash body. A planet is a celestial body. Question number 4. Each planet has its own path of movement known as what we say? The path where planets rotate, we called as the orbit. Yes, each planet has its own path of movement known at the orbit. Fifth one question, the Earth is a dash planet. Earth is a dash planet. In solar system, we say that Earth is an unique planet. Because why we say Earth is an unique planet? In only Earth, people live their life. So we say that Earth is an unique planet. In next class, we learn detailed about the Earth. Okay, dear students, in this session, we learnt about solar system, geocentric model, who expounded geocentric model, what you mean by heliocentric model. We learnt about planets and the sun. I hope you understood and enjoy the class. In next class, we continue the same topic, the sky. In that, we continue learn about the earth. Thank you for your cooperation.